Hey folks, good morning and welcome back to the channel. So we have got parity, it really is drawing upon us now. The original date was set for the 31st of this month, it's now set for around the 13th or the 14th of next month. That seems to be a definitive date. We do have a podcast coming up Tuesday, the likelihood it's going to be late in the evening, so that will come out on Wednesday, and that will be with the L1 Task Force project manager. This is really important for us to get these feedback loops, especially by voice, because you can get so much answered in that time. You can just really pick at things, you can get direct answers, it's really good. But what's most important for us right now as a community, and those still here, still sailing along, still part of the LUNC ship, is that parity is upon us. Why is parity so important? Well, there's been so many things that we've had to do. One thing to note is we were handed a blockchain that was shattered. It was broken and it just simply didn't work anymore. What we was left with was a very, very slimmed down kind of skeleton system that did work. Now we're turning back everything. Everything's getting turned back on. It's, you know, we're getting to a point where there's not really much for the L1 team to do once we reach parity, and that's the whole point of creating the USTC testnet, which is a whole different ballpark on its own, but ultimately that's going to become more and more apparent as we come out of parity. They need things to do, and it's all coming down to, you know, what is most important, because time, money, resources, it's all limited, and we need to be as thoughtful, considerate, and intelligent as we can about these situations that are in hand currently. USTC is definitely, for me, there's something there now. Clearly, it's any legal troubles are in the wind by the looks of things, and we're really not part of that system. We're starting to show that we're following our own road and we're doing our own thing. This is so important. So, like I was saying, the USTC testnet is more or less, it's actually a testament to the L1 paying attention to what's going on in the broader community, because that is really important. That is what it's going to set us aside from where we are now to where we can be in 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 months time with an incremental repeg. Parity is, there's going to be so many things that could go wrong, but I honestly, from what I can tell, speaking with the different developers and then speaking with people that I know about how this is going to go down, everything seems to look and act as if it's all going to go as well as it could be. And this is also really important for us, because this is a very important upgrade. So if you're on Medium, you should probably subscribe to Lunkburn Army. I wish he would change his name to something a little bit more, I don't know, appropriate, but ultimately drop him a follow, because these sprint meetings that come up, they contain literally everything, and getting these cross-chain liquidity assessments done. So I've spoken so many times about, you know, these IBC connections and it being really important to dive into as many as we can, but we need to assess the situation. We need to understand if that is actually beneficial for us or if it's not. So in these sprint meetings, you can see that they're using a system. This is actually Trello, which is really good. A lot of people with huge companies actually use Trello, and it's a really good way for them to show us that, hey, look, we've always got things that we're doing. There's always things for people to pick up. Nobody's ever stood there asking someone, what's next? There's things, there's tickets, pick up a ticket, you know, get it done. Once you've done it, put it in the done box and then go back, find another one and get it going in progress, get it put through for a review. This is really good. Really happy to see systems like this being utilized, because ultimately things like Trello are free unless you want a real, you know, the upgraded package kind of thing. It's mostly free. We need, and this is something that's happened quite recently, is that, you know, the L1 team, all you saw before was all these different people in Twitter spaces, you know, just talking and arguing and bickering. You just don't see that no more. Things have quietened down. People are knuckling down. And, you know, we've been through this situation before where, you know, we're not popular, we're not trending, we're not doing too well, it's a low time. And then all of a sudden, boom, we did a 13x. And then all the way through that 13x, you saw different influencers getting involved, different people getting involved, everybody getting hyped up about it. And this is all just part of being involved in crypto. And you know, if you're not happy with those kind of situations, you probably shouldn't be in crypto, because it's not all smooth sailing all the time. There's going to be bumps, there's going to be speed bumps, there's going to be ups, there's going to be downs. And ultimately, we are all swayed by the BTC dominance situation. So going back to parity, I think once we reach parity, we get past that, we're going to start to see really good things happen, because they can get on with the more simpler stuff that I speak about here on the channel, like a smart tax system. I'm ultimately pursuing this as much as I can, and I'm going to keep pushing on it that we need a smart tax system, because yeah, it would be great for us to have a 1.2% burn tax, but you know, when we're doing well, when we're in these uptrends, we're really popular, we're doing a 13x, not when we're in times like this, when realistically we need to be as caring and considerate as we can be to projects, people, and trying to incentivize trading, not decentivize it and making people sit and think, well, I won't do that because, you know, I'm going to get taxed this many times, and really thinking about every single individual trade. You don't have this kind of careless system. It's kind of like contactless, very dangerous. Contactless can be for a lot of people, because, you know, just tapping that card 10, 15 times a day, and then all of a sudden you racked up like a £100 bill before you know it. That's reckless spending. And, you know, with that kind of reckless spending, as bad as it is, that's the kind of stuff we want to incentivize here in LUNC. We want people to spend their coins. We want people to do stuff with them. With parity, so many more things are possible. We move into a new smart contract system. Old smart contracts are going to become redundant, meaning that we can do more. We can work with more. You know, apps like, I think, Terra Poker, they upgraded the smart contract size. This is all something that's just going to become simply non-existent with things like parity. We move to a better system. We move to a more upgraded system. It becomes better, smarter, faster, harder. And, you know, it's not like it wasn't a good system before. If everybody remembers, before we went into any of this upgrading stuff, we had a perfected skeleton system and it never failed. It never failed. Everything worked down to a T. What you're going to see with the USTC repeg as well is, if we actually head over to Station quickly, this is some people asking me how I got like capitals and emojis in my name in the top right hand corner of my wallet. This is the validator wallet. As you can see, you've got the commission and stuff like that. So anyway, going over to I need to go back to the wallet. All of these stable quants down here simply gonna start doing stuff. There will be things for them to do. By the way, if you're wondering what this is and what this is from, that's 30 days worth of commission for a node operator currently. Okay, the running cost is like £2,000 per month. So, you know, I guess you guys can kind of add that up. But like I was saying, all of these stable quants, they're going to be working, they'll do stuff, you'll be able to use them, and they'll be utilized correctly in the same manner that they were supposed to be. And I think all of this is ultimately leading up to, you know, getting past parity, getting this USTC repeg. And if you're thinking, what is this big long-term goal, it possibly could be just turning back on the mint to burn system once we repeg USTC, and then creating an algorithm loop between that where, you know, it becomes profitable to burn down the supply. I think, and you know, mark this video, it's my own humble opinion, I honestly believe that's where we're heading. I think that's where it's all going. The road to getting to somewhere like this, right, it's going to be good, it's going to be juicy, because people are going to want to get involved. But when people want to actually get involved, it's not in times like now when you're saying to people, this could be the bottom, this possibly could be the lowest point that we're at before we start to move up. People chase green. They see green candles and they start, you know, oh, it's going to continue going. How much more is it going to go? And then what do? You go and you start looking at LUNC content. You look at the content of what is interesting, and then, you know, FOMO starts to drive it. You get all of these different factors that come into play. And then the best thing is, we're on the back end now, right, of going through the 4.5 years that you have to wait with BTC halving. We're leading up to that, and I just, you know, as much as a lot of people sit there and think, you know, I wish this would all happen today, I think if we plan this right as a community and we actually understand what's going on around us with external factors, and we time this incremental repeg and the mint to burn system of LUNC coming back with BTC halving, I mean, that seems like a recipe for like the utmost perfect storm. We would move up so hard and so fast in a time like that with an incremental repeg just happening, coming out the back end of that. It could all be very interesting. So for me, not thinking about next week or the week after or even when parity happens, thinking about these long-term goals at the moment and ultimately where are we heading? If you go and look at how long until BTC halves, it's got to be less than 380 days now. We really are coming into that point in time where crypto becomes interesting, and you can go back and you can historically look at that on the charts. You can see these things that have happened over a course of time with BTC halving and timing them all into the same thing. But yeah, it's all food for thought at the end of the day. Folks, if you enjoyed this video, if you like this channel, I hope I've earned your subscription by now. If you haven't subscribed, drop a subscription, drop a like, drop a comment on the way out. It really does help the channel grow. It helps the algorithm pick up the video and the channel. And, you know, it really helps me. Those small little, tiny little things just help. And if you feel like it, don't skip the ads. That really helps me too. It puts a lot more revenue into the channel other than just about £300 that it earns a month. Hopefully this is all going to start going upwards with time. I'm a diehard person. I'm here. The ship's still sailing. And, you know, this is what it's all about. You know, not giving up when times get really tough. Like CZ said, if you can't hold, you can't hodl. You won't be rich. Folks, stay safe, stay humble, stay aware. Beware of scammers, beware of doppelgangers, beware of anybody who pretends to be me. None of this is financial advice. Sorry about my nasally speech. It's hay fever season. Folks, I'll catch you in the next one. Shoo!